Well, good morning guys, and welcome back to the channel. So today, hopefully I got a good, quick, easy fix for that parasitic draw that all C5s seem to have. So I'm gonna go ahead and roll an intro. I'll get into this device you got here, do a little open box, we'll go install it, and I'll give you a real review. All right, so I'm doing this because a lot of C5s, mine and a lot of people I see online, after about 10 days or so, your battery just kind of goes dead. These things do have parasitic draws on them. Mine's not terrible, but sometimes I leave it and I don't put the battery tender on it. I'm gone for a couple weeks. It can be frustrating coming home and like, damn it, I gotta charge the battery. So this pretty much is a remote kill switch. Pretty much cuts your negative going to your ground. So pretty much you don't have any power when this thing's activated, but it's connected to your battery at all times, so it can turn your battery on and off at will. It's got a little remote. This looks like a normal key fob you use in tandem with your normal remote. In case you don't know, I do have a push button start in my C5 Corvette, so this kind of adds a second layer of protection, if you will. So to get that figured out, they got to figure out how to get power to the starter. So there's that. If you don't daily drive your Corvette and you live up north in bad weather and you got other cars that you daily drive, probably a good investment. If you daily drive your car, it's your only C5, you live in Miami, probably, not worth your time to do. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn you around and show you what you get out of the box, and then we'll go out to the car and start putting it in. All right, here we go. All right, we've got some instructions here. It's pretty straightforward, but you can see that. And of course, I'll go more in depth when I do the actual install out there. We got some hardware going to one of the terminals. Some more hardware that attaches to the terminals themselves. Now I do have the red top Optima, so I have side and top mounts, so I can get creative how I want to do this. Now one good thing is this little module, it's got some weight to it, so that gives me some confidence. It is a Chinese product, but it feels pretty stout. Cool. And this will connect to both your batteries to give this thing power, and this will connect to your, looks like, in and out, I'd assume. And, oh, cool. Actually, you get two key fobs, which is pretty cool. Oh, there you get batteries in them. Nice. So this looks pretty straightforward. This should be a quick and dirty, 10, 20 minute job. That's your antenna right there. It says the range is like 100 yards, but I mean, honestly, if it's 10 yards, I'm happy with that. So let's go to the car and throw this guy in and see how it does. All right, team. I went ahead and got it all wired up. It's pretty straightforward. I'll show you exactly what I did. There was one hiccup. Without this hiccup, and you know what you got to get, you can do this project in about 25 minutes. So it comes with this little guy, this little crimp clamp, right? The gauge for the C5, the wires, are way too big, and there's two of them, so it's just way too small. I went to my local auto parts store, and I got four of these guys. You're going to need two. These are for 2-gauge, and you can fit one wire in both sides, and then you'll sandwich it on the relay. I'll show you that in a second. So, now, I would normally recommend you should always disconnect your negative. However, the negative on this, there wasn't enough. For the one grounding wire, there's two of them, there wasn't enough slack. And just for timeliness to get this video out to you guys, I went ahead and did the positive side. And also for heat. The only negative reviews I found online for this guy is if it's too close to the block or too much heat, it can malfunction. So this gives me another foot or so to use it over here. I did have to get kind of creative with some gymnastics to make it work, but nonetheless, it does work. Obviously, the C5 Corvette is a side bounce. This little relay comes with two of these guys right there. So I used the one on the top post just to mount the supply wire for power to the relay for this guy. But for the negative side, you pretty much leave it how it is. You put the top post it comes with just to use this guy right there. You could do it down there, but just for uniformity, I threw it up there. On this side, you'll utilize the same little top post that comes with squeeze post deal. You'll utilize your second power wire to power the relay. Now, it says on the box that the relay, it takes almost no power. It will not drain your battery.
It says something like it would take 3 years for this thing to drain your battery without ever starting the car. So it doesn't really draw anything. So this guy, and then you have your little bridge right there that goes up underneath your relay. I had to mount this upside down because of the constraints of just the awkward and unique wiring of the C5 Corvette. And there's just like no slack in these wires. And again, the only way I can make it work was using the positive side that had enough slack. So yeah, that's the bridge. It goes to the one side. There's two posts, one right there, and then one right here. This simply connects underneath here. You screw it down. Now, on the positive side right here, I had to take the cover off the side post. Once you take it off, it'll slip off, and then you take off the factory crimp, uncrimp it, and then I crimped these guys for each individual wire, and then sandwiched them inside here, if you can see it. And then simply just torqued it down, and it's in place really good. This had a little connecting piece of plastic up here. I just tore it off. I don't think it would hit the roof or the hood or anything, but just to be safe, I tore that off. But yeah, I got it all plugged up, and sure enough, it works just fine. So to do this job, you're going to need a 10 millimeter and a 12 millimeter. Interestingly enough, probably some wire snipping tool. I did, when I redid these connections into these guys, just, you know, give me a warm fuzzy. I did put a lot of solder in them too before I rewrapped them in electrical wire. Now, I've never used this product. Until I have confidence in it, I'm carrying around with me one little wrench to undo this and this little post right there. In the event I get somewhere and the remote won't work, I can simply undo it and put it in the side post right there. I'll just leave it in the back of the car somewhere until this thing, you know, after 6 months or a year, gets me enough confidence that's always gonna work. But it's kind of why I'm doing this review for you guys. If it works like crap, like, and it just sucks in a month, don't do it. But I'll keep you guys posted. But yeah, so hopefully now when I go on my, you know, work trips for a while, I come home and I forget to put some tinder on it. I can just kind of use the remote in tandem with my car remote. So it's super simple. So now you have your car remote, right? So I have it turned off, and to turn it on, simply hit on if you heard the little relay. And now we can open up the car. Car's a mess. But yeah, pretty cool. And then it takes me a while to figure out which one's which, but I think off is off. Right? Yeah, so you hit off, it'll disconnect the battery, on will connect the battery. So, pretty cool, pretty simple. Hopefully, this will save me a lot of headache in the future. I was just getting so tired of forgetting to set my stupid tender. And I have a push button start for those that don't know. Right there, you can see it. Whenever I install that, the little control module, it does have a slight draw on the battery. So, before I put the push button in, this thing could last 2 months, no big deal. But that does have a very unique draw to it. And I get about 2 weeks and this thing will die. That's one of the main reasons why I'm doing this. But no, so we'll see how it works, you know? And I'll keep you guys posted on this fun little project. And again, this could work on any car. If you have an older car with a weird parasitic draw that dies the next day, this could be a good fix for you. And it doesn't look too bad. You know, you can tell something weird's going on there, but I'm not too worried about it, so. Hopefully you guys found this informative, and I will do a update on this next month or so, let you guys know again how it's doing. Man, this car is filthy. I need to clean it. Holy goodness. But all right, guys, go enjoy your weekend. I'll see you guys next time. Mark out.